As I've discussed in previous videos on UV unwrapping, the main two important types of UV unwraps are cubes and cylinders, but actually remembering how to unwrap these things is usually done by just practicing it over and over again. But as someone who studies a lot of theory based subjects, I like to come up with memorable analogies to try and memorize things a little bit quicker. So today I'm going to show you an easy way to try and remember how to unwrap cube or cuboid objects. As always, before we unwrap an object, we're going to first apply the scale. So in object mode, I'm going to left click it, press Ctrl A, and then choose scale. This is just in case we made any adjustments to it in object mode. Although of course this is a simple cube so we haven't done anything, but it's still good practice nonetheless to keep the habit up. Then I'm going to press tab to go into edit mode, then I'm going to make sure I press 2 on the keyboard so I'm in edge select mode, which will allow me to select edges. Now I can go into this memorable analogy I told you about. So I want you to imagine the letter U. Think of it as U for unwrap, and what we're going to do to this U is kind of square it out so it becomes a really straightened out U shape. Imagine a U on a digital clock or something like that. And essentially, to unwrap a cube we just need to have three of those U's in a row connected together like this, and that will allow us to create that cross shape we're looking for. So technically there's four U's in total, because when we wrap it around the cube it creates a fourth U as well, but just remember it as getting three of these squarish U's in a row. So let's go ahead and put this into practice. I'll left click my edge down here, and I'm going to shift left click these edges here, and then I'm going to right click and then choose mark seam, and you can see that has marked our first U. You can see it's rotated so it looks more like a C. Then I'm going to shift left click these edges here, right click, mark seam, and there you go, you can now see we have two U's together. So remember, now we've got two of our U's back to back, and then we're just going to get our last one here by left clicking this edge here, shift left clicking this edge here, right click and mark seam, and now you can see we have three U's and a row. And of course I mentioned it would create a fourth U, which you can see here, but just think of it as creating these three U's in a row. Then I'm just going to press A, U, and then unwrap, and you can see this cube's already been unwrapped, but it's unwrapped it to our cross shape here. Let's practice with one more example just to show that it works on any kind of cuboid object. So I'm going to press tab to come back into object mode. I'll left click my cuboid here, and first we'll apply the scale before we do any unwrapping. So press Ctrl A to open the apply menu, and then choose scale. Then I'll press tab to go into edit mode, and it doesn't really matter which way you do it, so let's do it this way this time. So I'm going to left click this edge here, shift left click this edge here, and then shift left click this edge here, and this time I'll press Ctrl E to open the edge menu, but you can right click as well, and then choose mark C. Then I'm going to shift left click this edge here and this one here, and that's going to make a really long U here. I'll then right click and then choose mark C. Finally, I'm just going to come to the end here and left click this edge here, shift left click this edge here, right click, and then choose mark seam. Then I'll press A, U, then unwrap, and you can see we've got our cross unwrap here, and it's been unwrapped nicely. And yeah, I thought I'd share that simple way to remember how to unwrap cube or cuboid shapes. So again, just remember it is that three U's in a row. If you want to learn more about UV unwrapping, make sure to check out my playlist here to learn more. And also, if you want to practice unwrapping something a little more complex with a combination of cubes and cylinders, make sure to check out my video on unwrapping more complex objects. Next time, we're going to be learning an easy analogy to remember how to unwrap a cylinder. Apart from that though, I'd like to thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Take care.